back with Lord Monckton and Ambassador Bolton. Lord Monckton, you have been asking for a debate with Al Gore for a very long time.
Yes.
Has he ever responded?
I have taken adverts in the newspapers for 6 months at a time. I challenged him in Congress when I was invited by the Republican minority leader on the Energy and Commerce Committee.
Yeah, but that was C-SPAN. Now you're on a real cable.
And he wouldn't do it. And now, okay, we're now on a real television
show. Now you're on a real, well, not, now, you know, it's still cable, but it's...
Okay, but it's still a real television
show.
Yeah, right. And after all, it's Glenn Beck. This carries a certain amount of weight, perhaps too much around the waistline. But anyway... I thought I'd get that one in.
I lose control of this show. This. All right.
Well, thank you very much. You've been with the Christopher Monckton Hour. Now, what I'd like to say to Al Gore is this. Al, baby, if you really believe that you
hang on. Look right here. Look right there. Tell him right there.
Yeah. Al, baby, if you really think that you want to raise the profile of this issue, then why don't you agree to debate with me on international television? The fees we'll earn, apart from anything else, would be enormous, and I know you'd love that, because money seems to stick to you very rapidly. I want you to face me in a debate about global warming, and if you don't dare, I want you to remain silent about that subject forever from now on. Are you a coward, or will you step up to the plate? Are you an armchair quarterback, or are you going to get suited up and get onto that field?
You know what? I learned something from Marty McFly. Don't call me chicken. Just saying.